Hello students, my name is Bhavna Singh. I am working as an assistant professor in St. Andrews Institute of Technology and Management. This is an online tutorial series on e-commerce. So let's begin today's session. Students, this is our lecture 2 of unit 1 and we will be discussing these topics today. First one is what are the various impacts of e-commerce on various fields. Then the second one, what is electronic market. Then what are the advantages of electronic market. And the last one is internet commerce with its advantages and challenges. So let's start today's session. So in the previous session, we have discussed about what is e-commerce, what are its various benefits, what are the challenges. Now in this session, we'll cover the impacts of e-commerce, that is how it is impacting our customers, how it is impacting our society, our economy. So all these things we will study in detail in this session. So let's first start with the definition of e-commerce. What is e-commerce? E-commerce means, in simple terms if you say, it is trading online. That means we are buying or selling anything online and we are doing the transactions online. And these are the general impacts of e-commerce. That is, first one is consumer impact. Consumer impact means how it is impacting a customer, how it is impacting a normal people. That is, it enables the people to shop online from anywhere. They can shop anything from anywhere and it is available 24/7 and they don't have to go to markets or they don't have to go to banks for the withdraw money or for make cash transactions, etc. So their life has become very much easier and convenient because of this e-commerce only. Second impact is direct communication with customers. That means some customers, they may be wary of not having a direct face-to-face interaction with the sales representatives. And the other issue might that people are not buying things online because of the return policy, as there isn't much opportunity to speak to someone or to speak with someone about the returning the product or returning policy. So these kinds of things are sometimes become kind of challenges for e-commerce. Then we have third, that is the greater choice. Now the people who shop online, they have a wider choice of what to buy, what not to buy, and they are obviously, there may be some issues regarding the delivery cost or the delay in delivery, but then also they have a wider choice on a national scale. Now e-commerce have many social implications. Like first one is impact on business. In this, the customers, they need to trust the e-commerce site and they have to see the advantages of buying through the e-commerce. Then second one we have, it also depends upon changing customer perspective. That means sometimes most of the customers, they become worried about the identity theft or some items are not being delivered on time. And so these are the reasons that is making the customers not to buy online. Then we have value, service and ease. That means customers can have everything at very easily and while just sitting at home and placing an order online. And most of the websites, they offer a 24-hour delivery also without any additional cost. Then the fourth one is security. Obviously, this is one of the biggest barrier that affects the consumer perception. There are number of ways to protect the customers and the website should also ensure that they adopt these security measures so as to reassure the customers, so as to provide some security features and the customers, they are not worried about their transactions lost or their identity theft or their delay in delivery. So some security features must be incorporated by the websites. Then we have business and society. In this, we can make communication very easily anywhere in the world. And by trading online, these businesses, they open themselves up to the global marketplace and providing the global reach of the products. Now we will discuss what are the impacts of e-commerce on marketing. The first one is marketing strategy of differentiation increasing effectively. Second, product life cycles are shortened. Third, greater use of digital promotion. Fourth, brands and retailers increasingly using multiple distribution channels. This means e-commerce is affecting all these phases and all the activities of a marketing are getting affected by the e-commerce. Like marketing practitioners, they have to cope up with the marketplace and they have to cope up with the national and international market, or you can say the global markets, such that they can make more and more customers, and they can locate more and more suppliers and most business partners around the world, so that it will be easier for them to do the marketing of such products. And this e-commerce, it also provides the marketing practitioners in the reduction of cost of creating, processing, distributing, or you can say storing all the informations that they have to do with the customers. So all these are the impacts that are affecting marketing. Now next we have impacts of e-commerce on human resource management. The first one is need for employees to have a broader range of digital skills. Second, workforce planning. Third, concern over the working conditions of staff working. Fourth, increased use of automation in e-commerce. That means we are hiring more and more employees and training them and training the staff so as to increase the sale via other digital options, and we are supporting highly seasonal demand, that is which increase the workforce. For example, during the peak seasons, you can say like in the season of Diwali or in the season of New Year, Amazon, like Amazon, Flipkart, these are the companies that they hire around thousands of extra staff during their peak periods in order to increase their sale. So like this way, this is also impacting the HRM, that is the human resource management. Now how e-commerce is impacting on operations inside the company. It provides logistics behind large scale e-commerce platforms and becoming more and more complex. Then it places greater emphasis on close relationship with key suppliers, maintaining the relationship with the suppliers who are supplying the raw materials to the manufacturing industries. Then we have economies of scale are becoming increasingly important. And then it is now relatively easy for smaller firms to sell online with the sophisticated e-commerce software, which is integrated with financial, marketing and other systems. Now these softwares through which they can increase their sale and they can easily relate with the smaller firms has become widely available due to this e-commerce. Now what are the impacts of e-commerce on finance? The first one is it requires a significant amount of investment, you can say, to set up e-commerce platforms and to integrate them with other systems. That means we required an amount so that we can set up a website or so that we can set up our e-commerce business. Then e-commerce likely to involve greater use of multi-currency transactions. We can do the exchange of currencies using this e-commerce platforms also. Then third one is impact of exchange rate change is more likely to be significant for businesses selling online. That means they can use this e-commerce platform to build or to increase the international sales or the sales on the worldwide, on the global term. Now our next topic is electronic market. What is an electronic market? An electronic market is an inter-organizational information system that provides facilities for buyers as well as sellers to exchange information about price and product offerings. It is primarily about the search phase of the trade cycle. The electronic market is most effective in assisting the buyer in a commodity market where products are essentially identical across all sales. That means market, electronic market is a kind of a website, you can say, where many companies, they contract with each other, they collaborate with each other, or you can say in simple terms, they trade with each other. They can buy from and sell to each other using this common technology platforms. So basically, electronic market is providing a platform to both the sellers as well as the buyers, where they can meet and exchange their stocks and exchange their commodities. They can exchange their products and prices also, and basically they can integrate advertisement or you can say product ordering, then delivery of products, payment systems. So all these things they can interact with each other on this platform, that is the electronic market platform. Now these are the functions that are provided by the electronic market. First one is they act as an exchange for business transactions. That means both the buyers and sellers, they are exchanging their information regarding the stock availability, invoicing, order chasing. So not only about purchasing or not only about transactions, they can exchange anything or they can exchange all the information regarding their products as well. Then we have second is they manages catalog content. That means it helps in converting the product information into a common format and which can be understood by all the parties, by all the trading parties, you can say. For example, they maintain a type of EDI agreement which is understood by all the parties. Then third one we have, they provide support to the trading process. That means trading process includes like you can say payment or shipping of products or determining a company's financial status or exchanging prices. So all these functions, they are provided by the electronic markets. Now these are the advantages that are provided by e-marketing. The first one is they provide better return on investment than that from the traditional one. Second one, it reduces the marketing campaign. That means it provides a less cost because we are doing marketing through the internet. Then third, it provides fast result of the campaign. And fourth, with the help of e-marketing, easy monitoring through the web tracking capabilities can be done and it helps e-marketing highly efficient. Next, we will discuss about the internet commerce. What is an internet commerce? An internet commerce is like a subset of e-commerce. That means in e-commerce, what we are doing? We are trading online, we are selling and buying things online with the help of internet. So this technology, this internet is providing the technology so that we can use this for creating, for completing our business transactions, for doing payment electronically, for placing an order. So all these things we are able to do this because of this internet commerce. That is why it is known as a subset of e-commerce, because we are using it for the e-commerce, for doing the business transactions online. Now these are the features of internet commerce. The first one is the full scale sales and marketing cycle. That means it helps to increase the sales and marketing cycle. We can increase it by analyzing the feedback which is given by the customer and we can assure him to fulfill all the customer's needs. So this results in increasing the sale as well. Then second one, we have identifying new markets. See, by exploring to more and more global audience, by using www or by using other websites, we can identify new markets and we can increase the global reach also. Then third one, we can develop a customer relationship. We can by interacting with the customers using email or using messages or using fax, we can develop a healthy relationship with the customers. Then fourth, it assists the potential customers with their purchasing decision. For example, we can help them to guide them through the product choices so that they can make a decision easily. Then we have providing the round the clock point of sales. That means e-commerce or internet commerce, the facilities, they are available 24/7 and it will be easier for buyers to order online irrespective of their location, irrespective of their time. They can order or place order anytime and from anywhere. Then we have supply chain management. Supply chain management, it supports in the supply chain. The supply chain is between the suppliers and the manufacturers or between the manufacturers and the dealers. So through online interaction, it supports the supply chain management also. Then we have ongoing customer support. We can provide the after sale supports to the customers also by using the internet. So we can by doing this, we can increase their satisfaction and we can provide a healthy customer relationship to the customers so that they can build a trust on other particular websites. Now, whenever we want to set up an e-commerce business, these are the various stages that we have to follow. First of all, we have to create an online product catalog using the World Wide Web server. Then secondly, we'll provide pre-sale support by sending emails or by sending fax or by sending messages to the customers so as to attract more and more customers. Then third, we provide a full transaction processing for placing orders. Like through secure servers, we provide the transaction processing facilities to the customers so that they can place an order online using the internet. Then after placing an order, we provide the delivery of product, or we provide the product information. Like we provide information like what are the products that we can be delivered on online, or when the product will be delivered if a customer has already placed an order, and what are the other services that can be provided along with them. And for some customers, they can be kept informed of new developments, what the new has come to the e-commerce, what new has come to the market. So we keep on informing with the help of this internet. Then next, we collect the details and store them in the databases through the customer's interest. And we can store the information or all the details of these interested customers through forms. We can collect the interested details from the interested customers. And then we can send the targeted offers to those registered customers whose detail is being stored in our databases. Then after that, we provide we have an interactive discussion facilities to the customers by sending emails or by sending messages or by answering their queries. So like this, we create an interactive discussion facilities for all the customers. Now these are the advantages of internet commerce. The first one is timeliness. That means we can access any website anywhere. It is available round the clock, and we can send any emails at any time. Then second one, it also helps in reducing the marketing cost, because creating an online catalog is much more cheaper than we create a printing catalog or we maintain a paper catalogs. Then third one is it provides better targeting of people, and the people with particular interested, they visit the particular places that they are interested in. And fourth, we have greater market reach. That means we can send information or we can exchange information with hardly any cost, and we don't have to pay any much extensive courier bills. So in this way, all these functions, all these features, they are provided by the internet commerce. Apart from so many advantages that are provided by the internet commerce, there are many challenges as well that many people they face. First of all, there is an issue regarding the authentication. Means some people or some customers, they need a reassurance that the payment that have made is to an authorized person, or it was an authorized transaction and actually comes from a authorized person. So like this, they need an assurance. Then second, we have a security. In this, all the customers, they want an assurance that their confidential information, like their information regarding their credit cards, their debit cards, so they want an assurance that these confidential details, they are not intercepted by anyone else. Then we have legislation harmonization, in which some issues like under which jurisdiction this transaction is taking place, what is the locality of the buyer, what is the locality of the seller. So these issues are public debate, or you can say the policy debate occurs. Then we have payment. How it is possible, sometimes some customers, they don't know how to do the payment or how to do the transactions electronically. So they feel a little bit difficulty in that. So this is also one of the main issues that they face while doing the internet commerce. Now students, it's time for the important questions of the day. First one, you have to explain how e-commerce is affecting our society as well as our economy. And then you have to explain how electronic market is being used in various organizations, why they are using it, why various companies are adopting the policies of electronic market. So you have to prepare these questions, and you have to study these questions, because these questions are important from the examination point of view also. So do prepare them. So students, it was all about today. It was a very nice experience discussing with you all guys. And in the next session, we'll discuss about applications of e-commerce in various fields and future of e-commerce, as well as the obstacles that comes into the way of e-commerce. So thank you so much.